It's Carolyn Herbert here from BBTV. I'm here with Marcus Ellis. How are we doing after that third pro win?
I'm over at Milne. I thought it was a good performance. Happy to get a win and happy to move on.
Face shows you're happy as well.
Oh yeah, I look good at Milne, don't I? So now Mark's not got into nothing, just good solid performance.
Boxed a very disciplined performance, didn't you? You do like to get stuck in, but today you stuck to your boxing.
Yeah, I'd get a bollocking off Scott if I got stuck in, so I stuck to what he said. I think it was for the better anyway, because it looked better, boxed better, more convincing win, I thought. So yeah, listen to it more often.
Yeah, so that's what you're going to do going forward. So third pro fight, how many more fights do you want to have for the rest of the year?
I think I'll have one, maybe two by the end of the year, and then next year I'm hoping to get out more regular. As I get older, I want to start boxing more. While I'm young, I don't want to shoot me load, if you know what I mean. I want to just take it steady and then keep just going. Come on, stop laughing.
I just shoot my load.
Yeah, that's not spunking. That's fucking.
Okay, carry on. So you don't want to shoot your load.
No, I don't want to shoot my load. I don't want to. You don't want too much ammo before you, but take it steady and increase it gradually.
Yeah, so you turned pro, was it 18 years old?
18, yeah. 18.
So that's quite young. So what sort of amateur background did you have before turning pro? Because you haven't been on the channel before.
Yeah, I had a good amateur background, quite short, but I had 40 odd fights, boxed for England, won European bronze medal, won 4 national titles. And I boxed a few good lads as well, so the amateur background was there. It would have been ideal to have done a few fights as a senior to get used to fighting grown men, but with COVID and with no boxing on, it just made sense to turn pro and to learn on the job.
And you've been sparring men anyway as a pro, learning that way.
Yeah.
Talk to us about the stable that you're in and the coaching team around you and the sparring that you're getting.
Well, Scott's got a lot of boxers and there's always people to spar. And he takes me out sparring all over the country, so I'm never short sparring.
I mean, in terms of your stable, you work with Joe Hughes, Jack Cutsby, and the stable's doing quite well at the minute, isn't it? What are your thoughts on that one?
Yeah, it's just getting better and better and better. I mean, Joe, we were out on Sky Sports show, Jack's just won tonight. We just went from strength to strength.
Cheers for the...
And there's Carwin as well. Carwin, he's... Well, you'll get too much praise, don't you?
And then in terms of your future, you've talked about the next couple of years, but where do you see yourself going in the sport?
Well, hopefully I'll get a lot of money. But realistically, hopefully early 20s I'll be knocking on the door for English British title. Keep learning, but yeah, early 20s I want a British title and take it from there and hopefully go all the way.
I mean, in terms of tonight, you've had your third pro fight. Have you got anything to say for your supporters? And any shout outs you want to give?
Yeah, big thank you to everyone that came to watch me. My sponsors, Scott, my dad. I couldn't do it without all of them, so big thank you to them.
What are your plans for the next week? Have you got any food in mind that you haven't had for a while?
No, just get back in gym.
That's nice and disciplined for you.
Yeah, now I'll be eating big.
What are you having, pizza?
No, I'll have an Indian.
An Indian?
Mm.
You look like a korma man, like it mild.
No, I've tikka masalas now and then.
Tikka masala?
Mm-hmm.
With a lassi to cool you down?
No. Just a bit of ale.
Cheers, Marcus.
Nice one.
Have a good one.
Cheers.